see a lot of old faces that you only see at funerals. But it's nice to meet you in a more jovial environment.
Text your friend to tell another friend to touch down right here at the Cornhill. And there's also some activities happening in the building. So if you want to go in there and look at some archives of the Windrush, feel free to do that. And we've got our next artist coming up.
I'll take you back into history, because today we are really celebrating some players. And I thought the best way to do that was to talk about the history of black people from the Caribbean and how it's important that we continue to celebrate and honor these players.
Yeah man, it's a pleasure to be here celebrating the Windrush. You know what I mean, the generation of the Windrush. We have to pay homage to our elders who come here and help to build up the UK, you know what I mean?
Feeling like I'm feeling, natural vibe and flowing like the wind. Giving like I'm leaving, all my life I've been living for. CG birds and the bees give praises. What happened to the human races? All they do is promote hate. Love is all we need.
So the next person that we've got on is, I'm really looking forward to this. When I asked this young man whether he'd come and do one of his pieces, poetry, spoken word, he was quite excited because he says, and I've just written something which is just so apt for our elders and the bravery that they went through. So I'm not going to delay in introducing Curtis Block, spoken word, and his company is Tis Respect, Curtis Block.
Or should I say in French?
Curtis Block.
So what does it mean to be black? Can we overcome discrimination? What does it mean to be black if we are united as one nation? What does it mean to be black? Can we struggle yet survive? What does it mean to be black? Well, ask yourselves, what does it mean to be alive? What does it mean to be alive? Thank you very much.
Turn it up.
Check some company.
Everything has got to be earned. Hold on to those who stick by your side. I've got mine. They say. Expect the unexpected. Be careful who you wear. Always be wary. Now I've learned.
And then we'll get some beats going and I'm gonna start rapping for you. I wanna live and wanna mark history. To be made, you don't need to blow in any industry. People don't forget me, not just a bait face. I've been told I make people happy on a rainy day. See, world peace, we've always been screaming out. But first, let's rest our minds, no more reaching out. Role models like Kim and Kylie. What about Rosa Parks and me? 10-year-olds dyeing their hair like Rihanna. The media is the problem and matter. The underground scene is too underrated. I don't care about another rapper getting faded. Got UK rap telling us about the real streets and the female rappers with the real underground queens. See, mainstream artists, the number ones and they're fiending. But you're alive and you're still breathing. Wish we can go back to the 1990s when music was all about fun and less violence. You see guys in a rap video, glamorizing a bunch of crap in their video. I don't care for it, I'm just done with it. And I don't wanna see it no more. What you know about shopping, cause you're 13, trying to support your family, and you're thirsty, and you're hungry. Mummy's out getting drunk under the flats. You think this guy's your dad, but you don't know for a fact. He's always around, beating your mom, but well, he's in a trap. Try to live with granny, but granny's on different stuff. She doesn't know what it's like for you to grow up, and she expects more from you, but you have nothing to give.
Bless the Lord, everybody. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks and praise for your goodness and for your mercy and for your loving kindness that you bestowed upon us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for assembling ourselves together today. Heavenly Father, we pray for the cooks, Lord Jesus. Continue to bless them, dear God. We thank you for your provision today, dear God, because we recognize you, because you're not just our provision, but you're also our provider. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We pray, oh God, that you bless the food right now, oh God, and make it a nourishment to our body. We pray and ask for your mercies in Jesus' name. Amen.
Be lonely. Certainly not me anyway.
Neither me. Anybody wants a companion?
Don't wanna be lonely. I don't wanna be alone. I don't wanna be lonely. No, no, no. I don't wanna be alone. Tell me where did it go wrong? You just up and left from the bottom of my heart. see, yes. Oh, I never thought this be me winding up like this. Cause every time that I get home,
it's a love I'm in.
Cause I don't wanna be lonely. No, 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 I don't wanna be alone.
But he was famous for another program back in the day. Yeah, has anybody seen the theme tune? Okay, which is what they should have been doing back in the day, but they never did it then. And number 15, name the man and his profession.
All right. Well, so if you just have a look, we've got polka dot.
sure some of you can really remember this type of stuff, because it really was that kind of two-piece thing where you could have the dress, then you could have the overcoat, so you've got two bits to it. And also, obviously, if you had the hats as well. So, I mean, this is just a real example of the 40s, 50s and 60s. Again, like I said, they're coming back to us again. So thank you, Carol. This really reminds me of the sort of really 60s. Again, like I said, if you check, I mean, this beautiful detail on here. She's going to take her jacket off. So there we go. I mean, Sally's really showcasing it. Thank you, Sally.
You're welcome.
And then we've got Charlotte. You're talking about a tea dress, but what they've got in there, all the colours in, you've got the beautiful mustard, you've got the dark navies, and it just accentuates every part of your body. So you've got a beautiful, beautiful line here, it nips in here, and you've just got your midi length there. So, I mean, this really suited a lot of women, I think, because it just done everything it needed to do. So let's just say thank you to Charlotte. And then we've got the lovely Shell, is that right? And we've got Shell, she's now coming in. So what Shell's wearing here now is very much a spin-off of what Sally and Carol were wearing. As you can see, these hats were everywhere. Okay? Again, you're looking at, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? She's done that so well. I mean, you've got to look at the print, ladies and gentlemen. The print, again, it was so typical in that era. 50s, 60s, 70s and 80s. I work in fashion now, and I honestly have that type of dress in my wardrobe. So like I said before, it's come all the way back to us. So we set the trend. So just take a look at that, I think it's lovely. A good, really great round of applause for Shell. So Supporting each other. Karen, Doreen, Max, every single person who's done something for this
participate today. I take my hat off to you, because it's not easy. So thank you all so very, very much. So we're welcoming now Roy Graham. Thank you, ladies.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. Let me hear you. Look, it's a great privilege for me to be here speaking to you this evening. As some of you may know, I'm now called a returnee back to Jamaica. I was one of the so-called Windrush. But by the way, Windrush, where did you get that name from? Windrush. We never blows from here. We all paid our fare. That's £75, if I can remember. How much did you pay? £80? Anyway, I would rather call us the Caribbean flow. That we all flowed in from the Caribbean and we all mingled and mixed together. However, what I'd like to say, back in the day, the first thing what we find not very accommodatable is the accommodations. If it wasn't for the Indians who bought the houses and to rent us a room, not even a whole house, they just rent us a room. And that's what we had to put up with. For all you younger ones what's here today, you don't know how privileged you are as far as accommodation is concerned, because when you came here, it was very, very bad. Anybody can remember that? Yes, I'm sure you can. The other thing that I can tell you about, again for young ones, we never get privileged enough to have the employment situation. Most of the men was working a couple of factories in Ipswich here, which is well known. Cranes, ransom. None of us work in banks or buildings or something. We get all the rough kind of jobs. That's all we have. Anybody can remember those?
Yeah.
All right. So you know what I'm hitting the right note.
Let's go. And when I say local business, there was small business. And I have to say people like Mr. Oliver Paris, wherever he is, Hammond Devenish. These are young men who have now running their own business and have supported the Windrush event. And on the indoors, we have Doreen Henry and Karen. We can go forward.
Okay, bye. Thank you very much.
Hey, big old thank you, Charles. Just want to say thank you for each and every one of you, because without you, there would be no Windrush, right? It's all about unity. And we want to do something to dedicate, to say thank you to all our parents. Many of them have passed away, but we want to make this an annual event, you know? And we volunteer our time. Most of us work full time, but we volunteer our time because we find that this is important, that we are standing on their shoulders. There were many times that my dad used to say, no, when they went for a flat, when they went for a job, no blacks, no dogs, no Irish.
Yeah.
And because of what they had to do, we now have an opportunity to do what we're doing here in Ipswich and Suffolk because of them. So let's not forget that, okay? In the exhibition, he also tells us, we have been here in the UK, in England, since Roman times.
Yeah.
Not as slaves.
Yeah.
Because the issues with the young people, some of them, is because they don't know the history.
Yeah.
It's every single one of you, white or black or Asian, to tell black history, because that is world history.
Yeah.
It's not Black History Month anymore. It's world history. Thank you.
I just want to say a big thank you to Ipswich Borough Council. It's a pleasure working alongside the council. So give it up, make some noise for Ipswich Borough Council for making this possible, teaming up with us. Thank you very much. And like I said earlier, it's all about peace, love and unity. Equal rights and opportunity for each and everybody. If you agree, say yes. Your support is well appreciated.